Good morning, children. Today in English language, we will be studying chapter number 25, Uncle Ken in the Jungle. Okay, so this is a comprehension wherein Ruskin Bond is telling us about his Uncle Ken and they have a very funny encounter. Let's go through the chapter. Okay, Uncle Ken drove grandfather's old Fiat along the forest road at an incredible speed, scattering pheasants and partridges and jungle fowl as he clattered along. So over here they are telling us that Uncle Ken used to drive really fast, and he was driving a grandfather's car. That is, it's an old version of Fiat. So he was driving grandfather's car. So he was obviously supposed to take care of the car, but then this was an expedition. This was a trip to the jungle. It had to go wild. It had to go adventurous. So when he was driving at an incredible speed, at a very, very surprising speed, he was scattering. The birds were just flying here and there, children. These are some really beautiful birds found in the jungle. The pheasants, the partridges and the jungle fowl. Just to inform your children, jungle fowl, red jungle fowl, is a very, very rare species of birds, and it belongs to the hen family, and it looks somewhat close to a cock, that is a male version of a hen, but then it has its own individual features, and it is a very, very rare species. Which bird is a rare species? The red jungle fowl. Okay. He had come in search of the disappearing red jungle fowl, and I could see why the bird had disappeared. Too many noisy human beings had invaded its habitat. Children, what is the meaning of habitat? Habitat means the natural environment where the animals and the birds stay. Nowadays, children, we human beings are doing constructions and we are visiting the jungles too often, and the natural place of these birds and animals is getting disturbed, because of which they are getting lost. We are losing them. They are either disappearing or becoming lesser in number. So that was the same case. The writer is trying to tell us that maybe the noisy human beings have made the jungle fowl to disappear. By the time we reached the forest rest house, one of the car doors had fallen off its hinges. So, because Uncle Ken was driving so rashly, so fast, that the door of the car broke. The hinges, children, are the mechanical joint of the door which makes the door open and close. The mechanical joint with the help of which the door opens and closes. But then that broke off. So, that is the way Uncle Ken was driving the car. And a large lanthana bush had got entwined in the bumper. So lanthana bush is basically a wild flower, and so it was a floral wild bush which got twirled, entangled in the bumper. Bumper is the front part of the car. Early next morning, we renewed our efforts to track down the red jungle fowl, but it remained elusive. So children, the writer is telling us, though we faced so many difficulties, at first Uncle was driving so fast, even though we reached, we could not find the red jungle fowl, and then our car door broke. At the same time, the bumper had got entangled branches of this particular bush, and though they started their trek really early, but still they could not find the bird. The bird remained elusive. They just could not find it. Elusive meaning they could not find it. Returning to the rest house, dusty and weary. The meaning of weary, children, very, very tired. Uncle Ken exclaimed, "There it is, a red jungle fowl." So Uncle Ken saw a bird and he was really happy that I found a red jungle fowl. But what was it? But it turned out to be the caretaker's cock bird. As I told your children, that the red jungle fowl belongs to this huge family of from the family of hen, and a cock is a male version of hen, and so they look alike but they are actually different birds. So he got confused. The caretaker's cock was there and he thought he found the red jungle fowl. A handsome fellow, all red and gold. The writer is telling about the caretaker's cock, but not the jungle variety. So it was not the red jungle fowl. Disappointed, Uncle Ken decided to return to civilization. He decided, okay, maybe our trip to the jungle was waste. Our trip to the jungle was unsuccessful. We could not find this rare variety of red jungle fowl. He decided, let's go back home. Let's go back to civilization, meaning let's go back home. In any case, the weather had changed overnight and a light drizzle was falling as we started out. And they wanted to go back. Because they could not find the bird, along with that the weather was changing. Now it started to drizzle. What is the meaning of drizzle, children? It started to rain. There was slight rain. This had turned to a steady downpour by the time we reached the bridge across the Saswa River. So now the rain really started coming heavy. There was heavy rainfall by the time they came to the bridge across the Saswa River. They were on top of a bridge now. And standing in the middle of the bridge was an elephant. Now they have encountered an elephant, a jungle elephant. He was a lone tusker and didn't look too friendly. Children, most of the time, the jungle animals are not used to, human interference. They are not used to meeting human beings. So they get a little scared, defensive and unfriendly. So that's what happened with Uncle Ken and the writer when they met the elephant on the bridge. The elephant looked very unfriendly and it was a lone tusker. There was only one elephant over there. A tusker is an elephant which had these tusks, the teeth of the elephant, the tusk. So they had this tusk and that's why it's called a tusker. Even it's called an elephant. And didn't look too friendly. Uncle Ken blew his horn and that was a mistake. So Uncle Ken, out of his hurry, he blew the horn and the elephant got irritated. It was a strident, penetrating horn, highly effective on city roads, but out of place in the forest. The horn was strident, very loud and harsh. Strident meaning very loud and harsh. Penetrating, that it got right into the ears, it pierced the ears. The sound was so irritating, children. So it was very good for the city life where you have to go through the traffic and make sure people hear your car nicely. But then it was not meant to be in the forest. It was as if you are actually attacking the animals. The animals wouldn't take it in a good spirit. The elephant took it as a challenge and returned the blast of the horn with a shrill trumpeting of its own. So the elephant thought, maybe you're trying to challenge me, so I will fight back. The elephant gave out a loud, shrill, very, very sharp voice of its trumpeting. The trumpeting is the sound of the elephant. That was the response of the elephant. It took a few steps forward. Now the elephant is moving towards Uncle Ken's car. Uncle Ken put the car into reverse. He started moving his car behind. Is there another way out of here? He asked. So Uncle Ken asked the writer that, can we move out of here any other way? There's a side road, I said, recalling an earlier trip with grandfather. It will take us to the Kansrao railway station. So that was a very, very spontaneous reply, a very, very fast reply by the writer that let's move through the side track towards the Kansrao railway station and we can go home from there or find a help over there. Okay. "What ho!" cried Uncle Ken. "To the station we go," and he turned the car and drove back until we came to the turning. So Uncle Ken was also very quick. He had very less time because he was being chased by the elephant now. So he quickly took a turn and started moving towards the direction of the turn, which would take them towards the Kansrao railway station. "More elephants," I said, as two large pachyderms loomed out of the rain-drenched forest. Okay, so now the Uncle Ken is driving and the writer is updating Uncle what is the scene behind, how many elephants are chasing us. So two more elephants have joined. So now there are three elephants following them because they must have called out to their friends. The elephants must have called out the other group of elephants to join them in, you know, taking up this challenge. Who is this, person who's entered into our territory and is challenging us? Okay, so pachyderms, children, are huge animals like elephants, rhinoceros, hippopotamus, who basically give birth to their young ones, give birth to their babies, and are huge in size. So elephants are called pachyderms. Okay, so they loomed out, they came out very fast in speed to help their lone tusker. "There are now three of them." "Not my lucky number," said Uncle Ken and pressed hard on the accelerator. So Uncle Ken heard three. That's an unlucky number for me. So let me increase my speed. So he accelerated his car. We lurched forward, almost running over a terrified barking deer. So if you see, children, jungle is full of these different breeds of animals, different variety of animals. So you have to be careful. But Uncle Ken over here is driving so fast that he was almost going to go over a barking deer. So barking deer is a breed of deer, the ones whose sounds like a bark. When they cry, it sounds like a bark. So they were driving really carelessly, roughly and great speed, that they were about to, run over a deer. "Is your lucky number, is four your lucky number, Uncle Ken?" "Why do you ask?" "Well, there are now four of them behind us and they are catching up quite fast." So now, first it was one, then it was three. Now there are four tuskers running behind the car of Uncle Ken. And hilariously, the writer is asking Uncle Ken, "Now is four lucky? Will we be saved now? Because now there are four elephants chasing them." "I see the station ahead," cried Uncle Ken, as we drove into a clearing where a tiny railway station stood like a beacon of safety in the wilderness. So now they finally reached the station. Beacon is like a tower of safety where you can be secured and safe. So Uncle Ken and the writer reached the right place at the right time, safe from the elephants. The car came to a grinding halt. Why grinding halt, children? When you drive really fast, when you stop, when you put a brake, then ultimately there's a very, very rough halt, very, very rough stop, like a grinding halt. Okay? We abandoned it and ran for the building. The station master took us inside his tiny control room and shut the steel gate behind us. So if you see, the station master was quite, concerned. He got them inside to his control room and shut the steel gate so that the elephants cannot come inside the gate. "The elephants won't bother you here," he said, "but say goodbye to your car." We looked out of the window and we were horrified to see Grandfather's Fiat overturned by one of the elephants while another proceeded to trample it underfoot. The other elephant joined in the mayhem and soon the car was a flattened piece of junk. So if you see, the elephants were really terrified with this piece of car, this piece of junk, this piece of steel. They thought they were getting threatened by it, and they took it like a challenge. All four of them ran, they trampled the car, they overturned the car, they crushed it into a flat piece of junk. They completely crushed it, trampled it, and the station master told, "You will be saved, but your car is surely gone." Okay, The other elephant joined in the mayhem. Now, mayhem means children in the destruction, in the violent destruction. I'm the station master, Abdul Rauf, the friendly station master introduced himself. I know a good scrap deal in Doiwala. I'll give you his address. So he told that since your car is completely destroyed now, what can you get out of it? Maybe some scrap dealer. Scrap dealer as in children, the people who deal with these pieces of junk material, these pieces of steel and iron, they are called scrap dealers. Maybe you'll fetch some money for your broken car now, some money for your crushed car, because the car is destroyed, but you can still fetch some little money to compensate for your huge car. But how do we get out of here, said Uncle Ken. Well, it's only an hour's walk to Doiwala, said the station master, but the Dehra Express will pass through shortly. It's only half an hour to Dehra from here. So over here, Uncle Ken was not bothered about the car. He was really scared of the incident. He was scared to meet grandfather as well. But first thing that came to his mind was he wants to go back home. So in order to reach home, he inquired how can they get there. So what was the route, children? The route was they had to catch the Dehra Express train, and from Dehra they would reach the station of Dehra, and from Dehra they would have to take some other route. They would have to take a pony cart, a cart run by a pony, the cart run by a horse, and they would reach their home. We got home safely enough, taking a pony car from Dehra station to our house. Where's my car? Asked grandfather as we staggered up the veranda steps. So they were so tired, they were dragging themselves, children. They were really tired, they were dragging their steps. Staggered meaning dragging their steps because of tiredness. On the veranda steps, it had a small accident, said Uncle Ken. We left it outside the Kansrao railway station. So what was Uncle Ken's response? It had a small accident, and we all know what happened to the car. So imagine the plight of grandfather when he would actually see the crushed version of the car. So Uncle Ken tried to, you know, slowly tell the grandfather that it was a small accident, that maybe the pain of his car would come slowly. He would not get completely shattered by the news. I'll collect it later. I'm starving, I said. So the writer said that he wants to eat now. Haven't eaten since morning, so he was really hungry. Well, come and have your dinner, said Granny. I've made something special for you. One of your grandfather's hunting friends sent us a jungle fowl, and I've made a nice roast. Try it with apple sauce. So that is such a funny incident. They went all the way to the jungle to see the dread jungle fowl, and here it was at their dining table to eat. Okay, along with apple sauce. So one of the hunting friends actually found a red jungle fowl in the jungle. They brought it to grandfather to share with him, and they were now going to feast. They were going to have the red jungle fowl. Granny had roasted it very well. Uncle Ken did not ask if the jungle fowl was red, grey or technicolored. So Uncle Ken was at loss of words. He did not ask, am I going to eat red or any other color jungle fowl, because he was so embarrassed, he was so scared, he was at loss of words because of the loss that he brought to grandfather after getting his car crushed. He was first to the dining table. He was really hungry. Granny had anticipated this and served me a chicken leg, giving the other leg to grandfather. I rather fancy the breast for myself, she said, and this left Uncle Ken with a long and scrawny neck, which was rather like his own neck and definitely more than he deserved. So over to at the dining table, all of them were now going to eat a red jungle fowl, which is going to be a very, very memorable, a good as well as a bad memory for Uncle Ken. Why good memory? Because he got to eat the red jungle fowl. And why bad memory, children? Because to hunt the red jungle fowl, he lost grandfather's car. Okay, so over here the pieces were well distributed. for eating. Grandfather got a leg piece and the writer got another leg piece. The grandmother wanted to eat the breast, and the neck of the red jungle fowl was given to Uncle Ken, and it was a scrawny neck, a very thin bony neck. There was not much flesh, but that's what Uncle Ken deserved for getting the car of grandfather destroyed. So the writer feels that he couldn't have deserved a better piece than a scrawny neck of the red jungle fowl. Okay, children, so that's the passage, children. The chapter is a very, very hilarious account about Uncle Ken. We have a few question answers, children. I want you all to do only 4 questions, children. I will be messaging you which questions you all have to write in your notebook. There are 2 exercises, exercise A and B, that we will be doing. And the other exercises we will be doing sometime later. Only these 2 exercises of the comprehension have to be attempted. So thank you so much, children. I hope you enjoyed the story. Have a nice day.